Who said drop dead? It's not a drop dead trailer, it's a drop deck trailer. The real trailer is made by the East Manufacturing Corporation of Randolph, Ohio, and this model of it is made by Weiss Brothers. This one is in the colours of blue and aluminium, or as it's known in the real world, blue and aluminium. Inside the box are a couple of bags of parts, and the model is held between plastic formers. Out comes the trailer, and there's also another part, which is the headboard. Okay, you want assembly, you've got it. And on this model, it only consists of fitting the headboard at the front of the trailer. Locate it and push it into place. Firstly, this is a drop deck trailer because there's a drop in the deck. After that technicality, let's take a look underneath. And the structure of the trailer is modelled very well. And in fact, the metal content of the model is very high. There are decent tyres on the wheels and the axles are nicely modelled. And there are hoses and tanks. And a nice touch is that the mud flaps at the rear are flexible. The headboard is super shiny and there's an East nameplate. And there are holes for connectors on the front edge. The surface of the deck is highly textured. And there are very good replica timber strips running down through the deck. The detailing of the edges is also very good with its perforations. There is high detail around the landing legs, and that includes what seems to be small plates and a winding handle. The legs have smooth faces rather than screw threads. Further along under the deck, there are some tiny graphics. There are nice silvered boxes between the axles, and the metal wheels are very detailed with their blue hubs. There's also a high standard of detailing at the back of the trailer, with the lights looking particularly nice. There are also more tiny graphics, including on the mud flaps. In profile, the deck of the review model was very straight. Included with the model are some accessories, and there are sets of rubber straps with ratchet heads. Also included are metal chains of varying lengths. Starting underneath, and the rear axles spin freely. And there's also suspension on the rear axles, which was more springy on the front axle than the rear axle on the review model. The landing legs are also functional, and you can lower them in the usual way by unscrewing. Let's now try the trailer with some different tractor units, and we'll start with a WSI model, and the kingpin is too fat to engage. But you can get it opposed, and the height is good because both rear axles are properly grounded. Next up, we have a Diecast Masters International tractor, and here the kingpin doesn't clip into place, but it's a better fit. And again, it poses well, and both rear axles are grounded. The third tractor we'll test is a Sword model, and unsurprisingly, as these models have a similar heritage, the kingpin fits fine. And again, the rear axles are grounded. And if you do have a tractor with coiled lines and adapters at the end, then you can plug these into the holes on the trailer, and that's much better than having them flap around. Of course, trailers always look best with a load on board, so here are some tower crane sections. And this is where the accessories come into play, because you can properly strap down the load. The ratchet end of the strap fits over one edge of the deck, and the hook at the other end of the strap can be directly put over and onto the deck edge. And for a load like this, the rubber straps work very well. You can also use the chains to tie down a load, and you only need to try to use the right length chains for any particular load that you're trying to fix. This East drop deck trailer is a high quality model from Weiss Brothers. It's very well made with a high metal content, and there's enough details to give it an authentic appearance. It's also a nice touch that chains and straps are included with the model. Overall, this is a nice model, which is very good.